It is a matter of faith that hopefully you get before you leave this place. Please ensure you have a copy to take home to learn more about this great woman. As we launch this ever-first memorial lecture on the legacy of Mother Kearney, allow me to summarize who Mother Kearney is, who Mother Kearney was and is, from the experience of those who met, who lived and worked with her. And I love working with the acronym, Mother Kearney. The first Mother M, a model of living Christian and religious life, who made God the center of her life. Oh, she was an open-minded person and obeyed God's will, like Mary, our mother, and the mother of Jesus, and St. Francis of Assisi. She trusted totally in the divine providence of God and depended on God for everything. H. She was honest, hardworking, holy, and humble servant of God. E. She was enlightened. She emptied herself of all that she brought God in her life, like St. Francis. R. She was a radical follower of Jesus Christ, like St. Francis. She left everything. She left the comfort of her home and rooted herself in Christ. Mary, M. She was a mother of the little sisters of St. Francis and the Franciscan missionary sisters of Africa. And all of us here present, you have become our daughter and son, our mama, Kevina. And we pray for our mama, Kevina. This mama, Kevina, was available for God and others, the poor, the needy, the vulnerable, the marginalized, found her love. She was receptive and responsive to the Holy Spirit and the Word of God and lived a righteous life. Why? She yearned for God in prayer and His will in her life. Hey. She was knowledgeable about God and her call in religious life. E. She was empowering. She empowered girls, child, and women of the world, encouraged others. There is a book on her window saying, please get yourself a copy. And she was Eucharist-centered. She knew the value of the Eucharist as food for her faith journey. B. She was very vigilant in her life and lived her Christian and religious values to the full. I, the innovative woman, she is our intercessor, praying her for favors and miracles, and you will see what she can do for you. She was very inspiring and she was very influential as a leader. And very naturally. And she never gave up no matter what. Now, for you and me, what virtues can you borrow from Mother Kearney, Mother Mary Kearney, in order to live a holy, righteous life as a Christian and as a religious? Once again, I thank you for coming for this occasion and for all your support. We appreciate the contribution you have made towards this gathering Please do continue to support us as we continue to reach out with compassion to the marginalized and vulnerable of our society in the spirit of St. Francis and Mother Mary becoming servants of God. My God and my God. I wish to end the prayer of Mother Mary that is available for you. Lord of the harvest, we bless the so abundantly the labors of your servant, Mother Mary Kearney, in her service of love for the establishment of your kingdom in Africa. During her lifetime, she showed love and mercy to all those who are in need. Grant us through her intercession, we may receive the favors we now ask. I invite each one of you to ask God to manifest for the favors you need in your life now. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Mother Mary Kearney, servant of God. Mother Mary Kearney, servant of God. Mother Mary Kearney, servant of God. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Yeah, Jerry, Robert Religious, Professor Tabela, and friends of Brother Kevin, invited guests, Dennis and Jessica. His grace attends his greetings to you all. God has been unable to be with us, though he had hoped and wanted, but the circumstances would not allow him to be with us. His greetings come to each one of you. And he has sent a written message which in a very short time I've been delivering to you. And for you to that, I'd like to thank each one of you for taking up in such a number for this inaugural memorial lecture on Malachian, the servant of God. I would like to thank the organizers for this event. And we'd like to thank Professor Paul George Davila for the wonderful presentation. And he has made Malachian land for us. Thank you very, very much, Professor. And so I give the message of his grace. It is with great pleasure that I write this message to all the people of God. In the morning lecture organized in honor of Mother Kevin family has come in good time. In November 2016, Mother Kevin was raised to the level of servant of God. The ceremony took place in Water Cathedral, and during the same Holy Sacrifice of Mass, which I officiated, the recital phase of the beatification and canonization of the servant of God, and Father Luther Mapela and Brother Hans, missions of Africa, was also inaugurated. The occasion was so attended, also attended by His Excellency the Nuncio to the Apostolic Nuncio to Uganda, Archbishop Michael A. Groom, SDVD, and two envoys appointed by the Cardinal to hold the three courses. It is now more than 2 years since this happened, and one would wonder what followed after that. I am aware that since then, the daughters of Mother Kevin, the little sisters of St. Francis, and the missionaries, the Franciscan missionary sisters for Africa, have been engaged in reaching out to as many people as possible to let them know who Mother Kevin was, what she did for this country and beyond, and why they believe that she should be raised to the rank of sainthood because of the visible works that show the triumph of God's grace in her life. The sisters' evangelization efforts are aimed at leading the faithful to know Mother Kevin so that they can see her intercession in prayer for any kind of need they may have. It is Mother Kevin's intercessory power that will enable those who pray through her to receive God's answer to their prayers. In the event that there are miracles and favors granted through her intercession, there is every hope that she will be beatified and eventually canonized for the great glory of God and for an increase of our faith. One of the sister's efforts concerning the spreading of Mother Kevin's name and the work she did is to hold the Mother Kevin Memorial Lecture at Top 4, the 6th Memorial Hotel. let this lecture be another eye-opener to many more people, because this Franciscan missionary sister, who spent more than 50 years of her life for the people of Inaugural and beyond, by various schools, hospitals, the Rosaria, and homes for disadvantaged children and elderly. Many of us, our children, relatives and friends, have benefited and will continue to benefit enormously from the services that Mother Devi left behind. I therefore encourage everybody to pray through the intercession of Mother Mary Kevin, especially for a miracle in cause of an incurable disease or condition that has defied medical interventions. I also call upon people of goodwill to support this cause by both prayer and all possible support. Dr. Simeon Sumanda, Archbishop of Ankara, and thank you.
For the message that you have delivered for this grace with the Archbishop. Dear friends, permit me on behalf of the entire fraternity of this great association to perform and use this as an honor to invite a guest of honor, the Honorable Justin Kasule Mwomba, to come and address this assembly.
Thank you so much. God is good. Representing the Archbishop of Kampala Archdiocese, Monsignor Dr. Richard Kayongo, the Vicar General of Diocese of Lugazi, Mother General, Mother Cecilia and Jenny of the Little Sisters of St. Francis of Assisi, Sister Miriam Duggan, representing the Franciscan Missionary Sisters of Africa, Chairperson of the Lady, the Chairperson of the Baba Catholic Foundation, the guest speaker, who is also the product of the efforts of Mother Mary Kevin, the leaders, people of God gathered here, Father Wayne in a special way, representing the baby missionaries. Ordinary people like me, friends of Mother Kevin, Inaugural Memorial Lecture. At a time when I was young, because the little sisters fed a little baby, they punished me, they paid me, they cleaned me, they straightened me, they nurtured me, they taught me, they groomed me to be what I am. Thank you.